Hi everyone, this is just a quick video to explain how to fill out Achievement Day forms. First form we're going to talk about on this video is filling out our static entry forms. You'll notice this year that things are a little different on our static entry form. There is a division and a group number rather than a class and a lot. So we're going to talk a little bit about that. And so here we go. So rather than having a class, which we previously had in the past, we have division and group number. So you'll notice, for instance, environment and earth science, we had division 26. So this right here is where you're going to put 26. And then your class number is actually the four-digit number underneath. So you'll put that four-digit number in that second column. Exhibit description, you need to fill out the best of your ability to describe that. This isn't for solidifying you into what you're bringing, but rather if your item gets separated from the exhibit tags that we bring or that we send you and you bring attached to your exhibits on Achievement Day night or at the state fair, we have a higher likelihood of being able to locate your items if we have an accurate description here. How many years in the project? This means how many years have you shown a project or shown an exhibit in this project area. So if I was doing entomology, which is division 26, class 2602, and this is my first time ever showing an exhibit in entomology, mine is going to be a 1 there. Now the state fair column is all about whether if your item gets a blue ribbon at the state fair, or at the county fair. So if your blue ribbon gets, or if your exhibit gets a blue ribbon here at Burleigh County Achievement Days, do you want it to go to the state fair? You do not have to transport your items unless they are too big for us to get into the trailer, or if you don't want us to transport them up in the trailer. We do our very best to pack them and make sure that they're safe and secure. So this is just, if it wins a blue at the county level, do you want it to go to the state fair? The last thing I need to talk about briefly are the signatures required on the bottom. The member needs to sign, parent needs to sign, and then you'll need your leader's signature. Now, if you are unable to meet up with your leader between when you get your forms and when May 15th happens, if you bring them into the office completely filled out and signed, we will send them to your leaders to get their signatures virtually. But ideally, you're getting those signatures before you turn those in to our office. As always, if you have any questions, please let us know. We are doing a forms night again this year, or for the first time this year, on May 14th. So that's an opportunity for you to come in. You can turn your forms in at that time. It's also a good opportunity for you to say, hey, look, I did this really cool project and I'm not quite sure where I want to put it. So I'll help you through that process and we'll get your forms filled out and ready to go. As always, let us know if you have any questions. Have a great day, everybody.